Congressman with all these issues.
Well, that's correct. Actually, I was thinking back, reflecting, getting ready for this interview, thinking about the first time you and I had met. I had heard you on the radio. I was working in construction at the time and heard an ad for you on KJFK. And a friend of mine and I, we wondered, is this guy for real? You know, is he, does he do this just to get ratings, or is he for real? And you were appearing at the Downsized Government Conference. I'm sure you remember that. And took the trip over to Austin to see you in person. And people need to know you are exactly who you are on the air. That's the friend I've gotten to know personally. And they're not getting anything contrived. You're a very real person. And found that out very quickly. And I wanted to get involved. You have an amazing talent, Alex, for breaking through media conditioning and getting people to think independently, oftentimes for the first time in their lives. And that's exactly pretty much what you had done with me. I started questioning things from the mainstream media immediately after starting to listen to you and challenging those things. I just always accepted things that on CNN that they were factual, and found out through experiences getting involved in activism that it's actually the opposite. Very rarely does the mainstream media report things factually. They always tend to have an agenda, always tend to have a direction they want to take things rather than just presenting facts and let those fall where they may.
And for those that don't have the TV on right now, who aren't watching us at PrisonPlanet.tv or the free feeds at Infowars.com/show, we're showing footage of you holding the UN flag while I cut it up, because the state police said there was a burn ban, so we couldn't burn the UN flag as we did every UN day. So they said just cut it up with a knife. And it turned out to be more dramatic than burning it. We're going to play that clip coming up at the bottom of the hour.
Yeah, not only that, but as you recall, burning is the appropriate treatment, appropriate way to retire a flag. And I think in retrospect, I'm glad we didn't burn it. That's not the way to treat the UN flag. We don't want to treat it with reverence. We want to treat it with all the disrespect we possibly can.
We want to wipe our butts with it.
That wouldn't have made for a very good video, I don't think.
Oh my gosh, it's some Michelle Obama toilet paper. Getting serious here, bro. It's all coming true. I can't believe that the patriots that woke us up were so right, like Ron Paul and those that came before him. Do you think we have a chance to turn this around because we did get a jump on them?
I really do. And if I didn't think we had a chance, obviously I wouldn't be running for office. At the same time, I think we have a responsibility to our kids and our grandkids. You know, I have six kids. I now have a grandbaby. I don't know if you know that. My 21-year-old daughter,
incredible.
Karen, shout out to Karen, by the way. She just gave birth to little Emery, and beautiful, healthy baby. She was born 5 weeks early, but not a thing wrong with her.
Congratulations, brother.
Yeah. So we have a responsibility to them at the very least to try. We've got to be able to look back, regardless of what the future holds, to be able to say, you know, we got to be able to look them in the eye and say we did everything we possibly could do. And that's part of this. But in addition to that, no, I genuinely believe it can be turned around. It didn't get this way overnight. It's not going to happen overnight. It's going to take years, if not decades. But I do see things trending in the right direction. You had mentioned some folks that have gotten elected, Justin Amash, Congressman Tom Massey, Raul Labrador. These are all guys that are moving things in the right direction. And you asked what I would do in Congress. I see my role as kind of two roles, actually. Number one, kind of a forward air observer. I think one of the ways to restore the republic is to strengthen state and local governance, and most importantly, self-governance. And I think one of the ways that we can do that is, as a congressman, I could see kind of giving our state and local officials heads up of what's taking place in Congress, so that they can be anticipatory with the things they do.
That's what congressmen should be. That's why the senators used to be elected by the legislature. Exactly. So they were forward observers, but the 17th Amendment got rid of that the same year we got the income tax and the Federal Reserve 100 years ago. I think that's a great idea to say, since we don't have the Senate anymore, it's imperial, we should just see our representatives of the House more like forward observers.
Absolutely. And we can help our state and local governments and the people kind of gird themselves against federal overreach. The second thing, I think...
Stay there, Steve Lane. We're coming back. Steve Lane for Congress.com. Give him your Twitter account. I just tweeted you.
Oh, @LaneForTN, LaneForTN.
We're going to plug it when we come back again. Straight ahead, Steve Lane is our guest. He'd make a crackerjack liberty-based congressman. He's running against an establishment type. We're going to talk about that when we come back. Stay with us.
Listen up, all you preppers and survival enthusiasts. Sigma 3 Survival School has a brand new survival instructor training program that will teach you everything you need to know about survival and then license you to teach our survival programs so you can make a substantial profit from it. If you have always wanted to learn to be completely self-reliant and would like to make money at it, then check out Sigma 3 Survival School Survival Instructor Program at survivalschool.us or call 479-561-3886 today.
Do you ever feel like you live in an alternate universe? As the stock market hits new highs, the middle class are dying. Manipulated financial markets and economic figures, chaos on our border, China and Russia bypassing the dollar. Life is getting ready to change. You need to prepare to thrive in the new economy. Go to babyboomerbackupplan.com or call 888-507-8789. That's 888-507-8789.
I began to get into iodine a few years ago because it was helping me and my family so much get healthy and detoxify. Most people know that iodine deficiency has been a crisis around the world. Iodine is key to so many of the body's functions, especially the thyroid. I discovered a product being developed by Dr. Group. You now know it as Survival Shield True Nascent Iodine that your body can really absorb. Then, about a year ago, he said, listen, if you think this is powerful, I'm going to come out with rare earth, deep earth crystals. And the results that I personally have had have been life-changing. Nobody else has got iodine based on these pure crystals, ladies and gentlemen. This is innovating, and the best part is it helps fund InfoWars.com, the radio show, the TV show, the whole media operation promoting true libertarian ideas.
For a limited time, experience the ancient power of Survival Shield X2. Take advantage of this unprecedented 30% off super detox special at InfoWarsLife.com.
It's been said, those who control the food control the people. Are you concerned about GMO foods making you sick and affecting your mind? Many people suffer from lack of energy, insomnia, loss of stamina, weight gain, and the inability to think clearly. Genetically modified crops, processed foods, and toxic chemicals can compromise your health and are silently destroying your digestive system, which accounts for 80% of your immune system. Take back control of your health with Pro-EM1 Probiotic from Terraganics. Pro-EM1 Probiotic helps protect your body against irritable bowel syndrome, constipation, Crohn's disease, celiac disease, diabetes, the common cold, and much more. And including a powerful probiotic like Pro-EM1 as part of your daily routine puts you back in control and prevents you from becoming a mindless zombie manipulated by the pharmaceutical and GMO agendas. Call Terraganics at 866-369-3678 or visit Terraganics.com. TerraGanix.com.
A 30-day GMO-free emergency food supply for only $99 at 30dayfoodsupply.com. You can purchase Oregon Trail Foods' one-month supply of high-quality, nutritious, and healthy emergency meals. For less than $100, these vegetarian meals are naturally high in fiber, carbs, and protein, and they're packed with oxygen absorbers in Mylar pouches. They're completely free of any artificial flavors and colorings, have a 20-year shelf life, and take up to 70% less space than number 10 cans. They even offer a gluten-free option. Oregon Trail Foods and 30dayfoodsupply.com. Keep prices low by buying directly from the producers in Oregon and then passing the savings to you. Purchase a 30-day, 90-serving emergency food supply for only $99 this month, and $10 ships your entire order. Visit the website at 30dayfoodsupply.com or call 541-229-0010. That's 30dayfoodsupply.com, where they make preparedness affordable. 30dayfoodsupply.com.
Come, you masters of war. Here they build the big guns.
Lane4TN, or Tennessee is his Twitter. His website, stevelaneforcongress.com. I think people should go there and support this guy, or you're totally insane. He's a great dad, grandfather as well. And it's, again, at Lane4TN. Right there, he needs to get a lot of followers. He's basically just now launching his campaign. I've talked to him for months about this. He's got the demographics to win. And the way they sell the incumbent is, oh, he's an establishment person like Cantor. He can get things done. We need senior people to bring back stuff to the state. the same Republican leaders that won't control the border. We need a rebellion, and we need to overthrow the Republican Party establishment and the Democratic Party establishment and elect grassroots people that don't want to suicide the country. Lane's website is stevelaneforcongress.com, and I want people to go there. I want them to volunteer, donate. I know that we're on, I don't know, like six stations at least, all over Tennessee, including in his district. So everybody needs to support Steve Lane. And bottom line, he'll educate folks in the campaign. But Steve, you got a good chance of winning. I mean, I'm endorsing you right here. I know people can go find your videos on YouTube, you interviewing Tony Brown, you name it. You know, just really eloquently breaking down the ideas of liberty 18 years ago on TV with myself. We're going to play a clip coming up of you standing right there while I'm cutting up the UN flag. But the whole issue here is, they're killing the country right now. Look at the Republicans are doing nothing about the border right now. Boehner and the rest of them. So we need to get you in there. But before you get to your second point, forward observer there for the states to return balance to the federal system. Before you get to your second point, tell us about why people should vote for you in the demographics. You have a really good chance of winning in the primary if our audience especially gets behind you.
Absolutely. You'd mentioned earlier, I think maybe somebody typed it wrong. The incumbent I'm up against is one of the top 10 most vulnerable congressmen.
Yeah, that's what I thought. When I read that, I thought it was backwards because you told me he was one of the most vulnerable. And then I read that and thought, did Steve send us this bio? I apologize.
I might have mistyped it, but yeah, I did. But top 10 most vulnerable. He's had some controversy in his past.
No, I read it wrong. I'm looking at it again. It is top 10 most vulnerable. Anyways,
there's been a little controversy in his past. I think what your listeners would be interested in knowing is that Speaker John Boehner not only supports him, he contributed, his PAC gave over $5,000 to the incumbent that I'm up against. In addition to that, the current majority leader that took over for Eric Cantor, he's also contributed to the incumbent's reelection campaign. So these are big supporters of his. Daryl Issa is another one. You know, he is bought and paid for, I believe, by House leadership. And so I think that's almost reason enough alone to get him thrown out. As far as myself, why they should vote for me, you know, thank you very much for the ringing endorsement. Anybody that knows me knows that I'm the exact opposite. I can't be bought and paid for. I'm a very issues-driven guy. I don't care if there's a D or an R in front of your name. I'm going to work with folks that will work on the issues of freedom and liberty and the Constitution, and as long as they'll do that, if they'll embrace those issues, I'm going to work with them.
I think it's fair to say you probably 99% agree with, say, a Ron Paul.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I got to say, I really like, it's funny, I don't, I certainly don't try and copy Senator Rand Paul, anything like that, but we're operating in parallel tracks. It's pretty fascinating. A lot of times I'll do things for, say, reaching out to new folks. I always say, you know, if you want to grow the church, you got to reach out to the unchurched. And so the Republican Party, I am in a Republican primary. You do have to choose a party. And the Republican Party most closely aligns with my personal beliefs. And I believe the Republican Party is trending the right direction, although I'm still not completely satisfied with where it's at. But we need to be reaching out to all sorts of demographics. And I see Senator Rand Paul doing that. I also see his willingness to not compromise ideals, but understand you don't always have to throw the 80-yard touchdown pass. You can chew up, you know, 3 and 5 yards at a time. So as long as you're moving everything the right direction, then I think that's the most important thing we can be doing.
A long segment's coming up. We're going to play a clip, get into some calls, talk about how you want to be a forward observer. And I get in a hurry to get to somebody, and then I butcher bios. It was not you that sent it wrong. It's he's running against Republican incumbent, recently called one of the top 10 most vulnerable congressmen. I was thinking of you as being most valuable, so my brain twisted that. And then you, Steve Lane, were recently endorsed by the Republican Liberty Caucus. I know the Ron Paul folks like you as well. RLC.org. People can see that. StevelaneForCongress.com. Folks, you can go find his videos online. You can, he's going back 18 years, working with me. I probably had dinner with him 50 times. You know, good friends with him, know his family. And I just, it's so great he's running for Congress, and he's got a super good chance of winning. And I just can't wait to be able to call up and go, Steve Lane, come on the show, Congressman, and tell us what's going on. It's going to be so exciting. Because we've already got so many other great congressmen and people up there. I don't get most of them on, even though I can, just because I don't want to get them a bunch of political heat.
We're on the march. The Empire.